The Manila Film Center stands as a stark reminder of ambition and tragedy intertwined. Inaugurated in 1982, it embodied Imelda Marcos's dream of placing the Philippines on the global cinematic map. Rising from reclaimed land along Manila Bay, it was a monument to the excesses and contradictions of the Marcos regime. The film center was intended to be the crown jewel of the Manila International Film Festival, a lavish event aimed at rivaling Cannes. Mrs. Marcos envisioned a cultural renaissance with the Philippines at its heart. Yet even as the film center was being constructed, whispers of concern circulated. This relentless pace, coupled with alleged shortcuts and compromises in materials, would have devastating consequences. The year 1981 saw Manila abuzz with activity. The inaugural Manila International Film Festival was fast approaching, and at its heart stood the still unfinished film center. Imelda Marcos demanded a spectacle, a symbol of national pride. Construction workers were pushed to their limits, working around the clock in shifts. Stories circulated of exhaustion, of safety protocols overlooked in the race against time. On November 17, 1981, the unthinkable happened. A section of scaffolding collapsed, sending tons of concrete, metal, and human beings crashing down. The collapse of the Manila Film Center was a disaster of immense proportions, a stark reminder of the human cost of unchecked ambition. The news of the film center collapse sent shockwaves through the nation. The official death toll was initially reported as 15, but rumors spread of far greater numbers. Rescue workers, hampered by the unstable rubble and the quick-drying cement, faced a gruesome task. Eyewitness accounts painted a harrowing picture. Workers trapped beneath tons of concrete, their cries for help growing fainter. Adding to the tragedy were allegations of a cover-up. The Marcos regime was accused of downplaying the incident. Access to the site was restricted, and journalists faced intimidation. The Manila Film Center, once a symbol of hope and progress, now stood as a monument to loss and alleged government secrecy. In the aftermath of the tragedy, a veil of silence seemed to fall over the Manila Film Center. The official narrative, tightly controlled, did little to quell the rumors circulating among the people. Stories emerged of rescue workers being ordered to stand down, of bodies being hastily disposed of to minimize the official death toll. The quick resumption of construction, with the festival only weeks away, fueled suspicions. Adding to the unease were reports of unusual activity at the site. Construction workers spoke of strange noises at night, unexplained cold spots, and the feeling of being watched. Some claimed to have seen apparitions, ghostly figures wandering amidst the scaffolding. The tragedy, shrouded in secrecy and fueled by rumor, took on a life of its own. The Manila Film Center, once a symbol of artistic ambition, became synonymous with tragedy and the unknown. As years turned into decades, the Manila Film Center remained standing, a haunting reminder of the tragedy that unfolded within its walls. The building, though completed and used for various events, never quite shook off its grim past. Stories of unexplained phenomena persisted. Visitors and caretakers alike reported feeling cold spots, hearing disembodied voices, and witnessing shadowy figures. Television shows and documentaries featured the film center, further solidifying its reputation as one of the most haunted places in the Philippines. Whether one believed in the paranormal or not, the sheer volume of stories and the palpable sense of unease within the building were hard to ignore. The Manila Film Center, forever linked to the tragedy of its construction, became a site of pilgrimage for those seeking a glimpse into the supernatural. Today, the Manila Film Center stands as a haunting reminder of the past. Its once gleaming facade is weathered, a testament to the passage of time and the elements. The true death toll from the 1981 collapse remains a subject of speculation. The official figure of 15 is widely disputed, with estimates ranging into the hundreds. Despite the passage of time, the Manila Film Center has not been forgotten. It has become a part of Filipino folklore, a cautionary tale whispered from generation to generation. The building stands as a physical manifestation of collective memory, a reminder of the human cost of unchecked ambition and the importance of accountability. The legacy of the Manila Film Center tragedy is a complex one. It is a story of loss, of alleged cover-ups, and of enduring questions. And as long as the film center stands, so too will the memory of those who perished within its walls.